Good afternoon. Today I will start toxicology. Toxicology is the study of properties, action, toxicity, detection and management of poisoning. Now, what is poison? A poison is a substance which, if introduced in the living bodies by any route, will produce ill effect or death. Poison is a substance which, if introduced in the living body by any route, will produce ill effect or death. Substance may be solid, liquid or gaseous, and route may be oral route, contact, inhalation or by injection. Now, toxin. What is toxin? Toxin are poisons produced by some plant, animal and microorganism that are highly toxic to other living organisms. Example, botulinum toxin produced by bacteria, alpha toxin produced by fungus, and abrin, ricin, curare, they are produced by plant, and venom by animals. Now, venom. Venom are toxin of animal origin which are injected by sting or bite. Example, toxin released by snakes, scorpion, bees, and wasps are not toxic when ingested. What is fatal dose? It is the amount of drug or poison that would kill 50% of test population. And what is fatal period? It is the time in which the person dies if given fatal dose. Classification of poison. Poison are classified here according to the chief symptom they produce on the body. They are first corrosive poison, second irritant poison, third systemic poison, and fourth miscellaneous poison. Corrosive poison are poison which destroy the body tissue by direct chemical actions. They are again divided in three groups: inorganic acid, organic acid, and alkali. Inorganic acid include sulfuric acid, hydrochloric acid, and nitric acid. Organic acid includes carbolic acid, oxalic acid, and alkali includes sodium hydroxide, sodium bicarbonate, and potassium bicarbonate. Second is irritant poison. These poison have their specific action on organ, set up irritation and inflammation. They produce irritation and inflammation of a particular organ. This group is further divided in three subgroups: inorganic irritant poison. They are again divided in metallic and non-metallic. Metallic includes arsenic, mercury, lead and copper. Non-metallic includes phosphorus, iodine, chlorine. Organic irritant poisons includes vegetable origin, animal origin and mechanical irritant poisons. Vegetable origin includes castor wire, seeds, madar and croton wire. Animal origin includes snake and insect venom. Mechanical irritant poisons are diamond dust and powdered glass. Third is systemic poison, affecting the nervous system. First effect, some poison affects cerebral system and nose and cerebral poison. Cerebral poison again divided in seminiferous, opium and barbiturate. Inebriant, alcohol, ether and chloroform. And systemic poison may affect spinal cord. Example, Nux vomica and Jansenium. Third, poison may affect peripheral nervous system. Example, curare and conium. Fourth, affecting the CVS, cardiac poisons, hydrocyanic acid, aconite, oleander, and digital leaves. They affect CVS. And fourth is miscellaneous poison, mycotoxin, and poisoning by hormones. Miscellaneous includes mycotoxin and poisoning by hormones. Poisons may also be classified from the medical legal point of view, that is suicidal poison, homicidal poison, and stupefying poison. So that suicidal poison includes organophosphorus, barbiturates, aluminium phosphide, that is sulfos. Homicidal poison includes arsenic oxide and aconite, and stupefying poison includes datura and cannabis. Accidental poisons. Common household items may act poison, example phenyl. Abortifacient, example marking net and cattle poison, sui or sutri prepared from the seeds of Arbus pectoralis or ratti, oleander, aconite, arsenic and salt are used for cattle poisoning. Next is arrow poison. Curare, snake, venom, aconite and ratti may be used as a pest over metallic blade of arrow by travels. Now question asks, what is the ideal suicidal poison? What is the feature of ideal suicidal poison? Then it should be cheap and easily available. It should be tasteless or pleasant in taste. Invariably lethal and in small doses. Invariably lethal in a small dose. Can be taken easily with food or drink. It should be produced painless and quick death. Organophosphorus and barbiturate compounds are commonly used for suicide. Ideal homicidal poison. What is the feature of ideal homicidal poison? It should be cheap and easily available on open market. It should be colorless, odorless and tasteless, so that it can easily administer in food or drink without causing any suspicion. It should be highly toxic in very small dose. Symptom and sign should resemble a natural disease. It should be rapidly destroyed in the body after ingestion. Lethal effect should be irreversible. Postmortem finding should stimulate with those of natural disease. White arsenic and aconite roots are commonly used as homicidal poisoning route of administration of poisons. Oral route through inhalation, absorption through skin and eye, injection in skin, muscle and vessels. Introduction into natural orifices. Excretion of poison. Primarily, the poisons are excreted through urine by food, milk, saliva, and sweat. Action of poisons. Some poisons may be direct, that is local, or local on skin and mucous membrane. Second is remote action or systemic action. In this, the action starts after absorption of poison in different organs of the body, example, organophosphorus poison. Direct actions, corrosive action by a strong acid and alkali, inflammation and irritation by diluted mineral acid, salt or arsenic, salt of arsenic or mercury, tingling and numbness of tongue tips caused by aconite, and change in shape of pupil by atropine. Gastroenteritis in arsenic poisoning. These are the direct action of poison. Indirect or remote action. They are shock caused by large dose of corrosive poison and heavy metal salts. Yes, example, arsenious oxide. Second is tetanic spasm, as in strychnine and naxbomica poisoning. Third is nephritis in oxalic acid poisoning. Oxalic acid also produces lowering of blood calcium level that causes tetanic like features. Next is shock. It occurs in tobacco, oleander and aconite poisoning. Combined action means both direct and indirect. In some poisoning, both action occur, example, phosphorus and oxalic acid. They act by their irritant effect on the mucous membrane of alimentary canal and also produce a toxicity effect in the system. Factors modifying action of poisons. First is quantity. A large dose, 3 times of fatal dose of poison, like immediate death by shock, while a small quantity, it produces only gastroenteritis. Very small dose of gaseous poison will cause death. Example, inhalation of hydrocyanic acid gas and methyl isocyanate gas. Physical state. Gas acts most rapidly, liquid poison acts quickly, and solid forms act most slowly when taken orally. Routes of administration. Rapidity of action depends on route of admission of poison. Inhalation. If poison is given by inhalation, most rapid action, example SCN gas. IV route, quick action. Oral route, less rapidly than above 2, and contact poison acts slowly. Types of poisoning. Acute poisoning and chronic poisoning. Acute poisoning, sudden large dose of a poison taken in a single dose produce acute symptom and sign. Chronic poisoning, a smaller or gradually increasing dose of a poison taken for a long time produce chronic poisoning. General symptom and sign of poisoning. Sudden occurrence of symptom in a previously healthy individual. Sudden occurrence of a symptom in a previously healthy individual is the sign of poisoning. Symptom generally appears soon after drinking or eating common meal. And third, a number of people may simultaneously suffer, example, in food poisoning. Fourth, gradual increase of symptom in severity and not promptly relieved by symptomatic treatment. Gradually increase in symptom in severity and not promptly relieved by symptomatic treatment. Immediate fatal effect may occur. A special symptom and sign. Some special sign and symptom of a particular poison may be found, example, in corrosive poisoning. Marks of corrosion will be formed externally on the skin around the mouth and fingers. They are corroded. Treatment of poisoning in general, which will be discussed in next class.